How does using a computer make bank reconciliation any easier? Well, if you're using a computer software like QuickBooks Online to do your bank reconciliation, they all depend on a very special number. And the name of that magic number is called the cleared balance. Now, before we jump right into the material, you should know that this video is only one video chapter as part of the entire bank reconciliation course, which is free right here on YouTube. So if you want to start as a beginner knowing nothing about bank reconciliation and finish as an absolute expert when doing bank reconciliation in QuickBooks Online, all you have to do is look in the description field of this video, down below the table of contents, and you'll be able to get the link to the full bank reconciliation course that's free for everyone, everywhere, right here on YouTube. Now, the cleared balance is not the balance you see when you ask QuickBooks Online to show you the balance of your bank account according to the QuickBooks records. The cleared balance is only the balance of the specific transactions within that account that you told QuickBooks Online were found on the bank statement. And if an item in your QuickBooks Online is found on the bank statement, we say that that item has cleared the bank. Now, it would help to have a physical representation of this. So think about this. In the days before the computer, you would lay out a copy of your check register on one table and a copy of the multi-page bank statement with many transactions on the other table. And you would look through them one by one. And every time you found something that was on the bank statement that was also exactly the same as the same item in the checkbook register, you would cross both of them off, and that's how you would mark them as cleared. But if you're not using a computer, it's still possible for you to make a mistake. It's still possible for you to cross something off on one side that's not found on the other, and vice versa. So that's why the computer helps us by showing us the cleared balance as we do this procedure. So when we do this inside QuickBooks Online, QuickBooks Online is doing something to help us. So imagine here are all of the transactions listed on the bank statement, and here are all the transactions listed in that same account in QuickBooks Online. And every time we mark off something as cleared in our QuickBooks Online records, because it matched exactly the same thing on the bank statement, every time we mark something off, QuickBooks Online will take the money amount of that transaction and it will add it to the cleared balance. Then when we mark off another item, then that item's money amount also gets added to the cleared balance. And if you imagine doing that for every item that we see on the bank statement, that means that at the moment we mark off the last item on the bank statement as cleared, that's the moment that the cleared balance would then match the bank balance on the bank statement. Now, you may well ask, what about those extra items inside your QuickBooks Online bank account that are not found on the bank statement? Well, if those extra items did not yet clear the bank, you would not mark them off and they should not be part of the cleared balance. And you will almost always have some extra items left over in your QuickBooks Online records that have not yet cleared the bank because we always know about transactions before the bank does, and we will always record it before the bank has an opportunity to do so. So if you have some extra transactions that did not clear the bank, it's not a mistake. You simply don't include them in the balances that you're comparing. And when you're finished, if your bank balance from the statement matches the cleared balance inside your QuickBooks Online, congratulations, that means there's zero difference between your records and the bank records, and you have proven that your records are correct. So, watch again the process as it unfolds so it makes sense. We find the first one on the bank statement, so we mark it off as cleared. That goes as part of the cleared balance. We find the next one on the bank statement. It matches everything that we see in our QuickBooks Online for the same transaction, so we mark it as cleared, and that money amount goes as part of the cleared balance. Next one, everything matches for the same transaction. We mark it off as cleared, and again, that additional transaction's amount gets added to the cleared balance. And again, we mark it off here if it's the same as there. And again, once we mark it off, that item's money amount gets added to the cleared balance. Now watch the most important moment. The most important moment is the moment that we mark off the very last item on the bank statement. Because at the moment we mark off the very last item on the bank statement and match it with the item in QuickBooks Online, that's the moment where the cleared balance needs to equal the balance on the bank statement. And notice it matches for only the ones that have cleared, and the few extra ones here at the bottom of the QuickBooks records are simply transactions that the bank has not yet found out about, so we won't worry about them. Usually these items clear on the next month's bank statement. But we know for every item that did clear the bank, we know that we recorded them correctly in our QuickBooks Online records because the balance of only the ones we marked as cleared matches the balance of the bank statement. Thank you so much for watching our video all the way till the end. If you'd like to be an expert in bank reconciliation, don't forget to look for the link to the full bank reconciliation course down below this video in the description field right here. That video is the absolute best video course you could possibly take if you're studying how to do bank reconciliation in QuickBooks Online. It's free for everyone, and it will give you everything you need.